Hey everyone, Myran here, and today will be the first episode of a series I've named Myran's Astronaut Academy. This series aims to break down each move Olimar has and explain how they work, as well as some good ways to use them. Today's episode will be focusing on all his non-Pikmin attacks except for Neutral Air, which I'll be saving for the aerial video. That means we'll be discussing Jab 1 and 2, Down Tilt, Up Tilt, Forward Tilt, and Dash Attack. Now that the introductions are done, we can get right into the good stuff. First off, I'll be talking about Olimar's Jab. I want to break down both Jab 1 and 2 separately to see the differences though. Normally, Olimar's Jab is a move they use in quick succession to attack with, but Jab 1 on its own has some nice uses which no other move in his toolkit can provide. Starting off, we'll look at the behind the scenes data of the move. Jab 1 is Olimar's fastest option, coming out on frame 4 and is active for only 2 frames. Its FAF, or first active frame, is 19, meaning you have to wait 14 frames after the hitbox goes away before you can act. Unless you cancel with Jab 2, which you can do anytime from frame 7 through 19. The first frame has a sweet spot that does 3.6% and pushes the opponent outward. The sour spot does 4.8%, is active on frame 5, and has a hitbox that pulls the opponent inward. This means, on average, the Jab 2 will connect with the opponent, since depending on their spacing, they'll always roughly be in the same range. Now that we've got the numbers out of the way, let's talk about general uses for Jab 1, as well as your specific instances to use it. As I said earlier, Olimar's Jab is his fastest option. This means it'll be your best way to get an attack out during a close quarter combat encounter, as well as being quite low commitment, having the entire animation finish in less than a third of a second. Aside from comboing into Jab 2, this move also serves two other important uses. First off is the ability to jab lock. This is Olimar's most consistent option in jab lock, as well as his fastest. When an opponent is knocked down from any attack and misses a tech, it is possible to hit them with Jab 1 and lock them there. You can do this a total of 2 times for extra damage. After you lock them, you can usually follow up with any attack, but forward smash on average is the best for raw damage output and easiness to hit with. The second use of Jab 1 is a bit more complex in its application, but can allow for big punishes when done right. The goal here is to hit an opponent with only Jab 1 and let the move finish its animation. A majority of the time, the opponent cannot properly react to what is happening and will instinctively buffer an option after the hit. This could be a roll, grab, or something else. However, you can exploit this flinch from them and go for a big punish. Maybe you're in a scuffle and you see an opening for a jab. Going for just Jab 1, then stopping, may make them buffer a roll away, allowing you to react and land a smash or grab for free. Another example is characters at the ledge. The best example for this is a character like Fox, who typically drops down from the ledge and immediately jumps before attacking. By standing at the ledge and using only Jab 1, you can knock him out of his animation and cause him to fall. From here on out, he can only use Up B to recover, allowing you to get a free down air punish. These are some extra uses for Jab 1, but a majority of the time, you'll stick to using it for setting up Jab 2. Jab 2 is unique because it can only be used after using the first part of Jab. Once used, it comes out frame 4 and lasts for 2 frames as well, and has a FAF of 17. Similar to Jab 1, it has 2 hitboxes depending on the frame that do either 3.6% for the beginning or 4.8% for the end. However, unlike Jab 1, this move will always have the same knockback angle. Jab 2's main goal is to set up for low, mid-percent follow-ups, reads, or tech chases. An example of this is landing Jab 1-2 on the opponent at lower percent. On most characters, you can't immediately go for a follow-up due to the opponent being able to spot dodge or get away. This means you can hit the jab, then wait for their defensive option, oftentimes spot dodge, and hit them with a smash as they finish the move. At higher percents, the move can set up tech chases or something similar. Maybe around 50 or 60%, the opponent gets hit by Jab 2 and misses the tech. In this instance, as long as you started moving towards them after you finished the first set of jabs, you could follow up with a jab lock or something easier like a smash attack or down tilt. Jab 2 is simple in its applications, but the strength comes in the ability to quickly get your opponent off of you and potentially punish them for missing something as simple as a tech. Down tilt will be the first tilt I'll discuss. Down tilt comes out on frame 6 and is active for 7 frames, finishing on frame 12. It has a FAF of 29 and does 7.2%. It's a relatively quick move, being only slower than Olimar's jab as well. It sends at an almost straight up angle, going slightly away from Olimar. The strength in down tilt is that you can use it consecutively to get combos on lower percent opponents who are heavy or fast fallers due to its low knockback. This means, depending on how the opponent DIs the attack, you can follow up with a smash attack at low mid percents or an aerial like forward air and up air at higher percents. In addition to this, the move has Olimar slide across the ground when attacking. This animation actually lowers Olimar's hurtbox as well, allowing him to dodge certain attacks if timed right, such as Wolf Laser. Lastly, the move is a strong two-frame attack, meaning when a character is recovering offstage, he goes to grab the ledge, the attack can poke under the stage and catch their ledge snap vulnerability. The hitbox for down tilt is quite generous, so I encourage you to find ways to use it on stage in neutral, as well as for ledge punishes. Next, I'll talk about up tilt. This is one of the 2 multi-hit normals Olimar has, with a total of 6 hits altogether. The attack starts on frame 6 and has a re-hit rate of every 2 frames with a final attack on frame 16. It has a FAF of 38. Each hit does 0.72%, with the final attack doing 4.8%. In total, all 6 hits add up to 8.4%. Up tilt sends at a 90 degree angle, or straight up, so it can be followed up with up air, depending on the percent the opponent is at. Alternatively, you can connect into another up tilt on heavier characters or opponents that don't immediately jump away at low percents. While this move may seem a little niche, it actually has a couple uses. The first and most commonly used one is after landing a neutral air, since it's your fastest attack that hits on both sides. Having it be multi-hit is good, because it can last a bit, catching opponents that may have spot dodged or rolled in on top of you. The more specific use of this move is its poking / anti-air properties. On stages like Battlefield, up tilt can poke through the bottom of the platform, and hit the opponent if they aren't careful, or shield poke if their shield is low. On top of that, the final hitbox of this move hits a considerable distance above Olimar, and uses the antenna to hit. This means the attack can be used as an anti-air if you read the opponent coming down on you and want to poke safely, since Olimar's antenna is in a hurtbox. While not being used as often as down tilt, I do feel up tilt has its place in Olimar's kit and does its job well. To round out the tilt trio, I'll be discussing forward tilt, an attack commonly looked down upon due to the bad reputation it has. However, I feel while being very specific in its uses, it does a job that other tilts can't do as well. Forward tilt comes out on frame 15 and lasts for 3 frames, ending on 17. It has a FAF of 35. It does 13.2% and sends at a pretty straight outwards angle, which makes it a viable kill move. The uses for forward tilt are specific in that it primarily serves two purposes: attacking when you don't have a Pikmin handy due to losing them or a desync, or when you want to punish an aerial without fear of it clanking. The first use doesn't happen too often, however some good examples are when you've just moved near a ledge or platform and your Pikmin desynced out of your line because of it. Forward tilt is slightly slower to come out relative to a smash, but it's quite strong and can still score a kill. On the other hand, it can be used in cases where you have no Pikmin and only have a small opening to attack. It takes 8 frames before you can act once a Pikmin is plugged, so sometimes it's better to skip that and attack with forward tilt. The second big use of the move is to beat out aerials. Since this attack uses no Pikmin, it's treated as a normal move and won't clank with aerial attacks. This means if you see someone approaching in the air, your forward tilt will at least trade as long as it comes into contact with their hurtbox. This is especially helpful for scoring kills while the opponent is approaching, since they're unlikely to consider this an option they need to worry about. Lastly, I'll be talking about dash attack, the other multi-hit normal Olimar has. Dash attack has 2 hits, with the first hit being active from frames 8 through 10, while the second is 11 through 14. It has a FAF of 37. The first hit does 8.4%, and the second does 4.8%, for a total of 13.2%. Since dash attack keeps Olimar moving during its use, it can be used as a cross-up tool as well. While not directly safe on shield, if used right on top of their shield, many characters can't punish due to the distance Olimar puts between the opponent and himself by crossing up. It's also a nice option to use at the ledges, since you can't run off of them. Since it lingers for a few frames, the second hit can sometimes catch opponents who move into that area thinking they are safe. As for follow-ups, if you land both hits, Olimar can often follow up with an aerial, generally up air, at low mid percents due to the second hit sending up and slightly outward. In the event you land just the first hit, the opponent will barely go anywhere due to the low knockback from it. While at the moment there are no confirmed follow-ups available that have been labbed, you can hit a smash attack if they've been caught off guard or respond slowly, or go for a faster option like jab or down tilt to try and start a combo / tech chase. Well, that wraps up the first lesson of the Astronaut Academy. I know there was a lot of information presented here, but I didn't want to skimp out on the knowledge I had. I hope you all enjoyed the breakdowns, and if you did, please feel free to like and subscribe. Anyways, I'll see you all next time where we'll be talking about smash attacks. Have a great day.